Yeah, this was like my route all the way home. It was always a cool hit because it was like, it was this embankment, you know?
This is the first one?
Yeah. So I think, I mean, at first I would just kick turn on it. And then at a certain point I tried to get onto the stair. And this is probably like, I don't know, maybe 80s, 87, 88 or something. Yeah. The stair ride. Money, 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 money. Gearing up to get down. Yeah, so basically being on the bike allows me to kind of be in the street. I'm always looking down at the ground and I'm picking up like random knickknacks to make my art with, you know? Oh, this is dope. You could see what it ate. Kind of sick, twisted. This is gonna look weird, but well, it is weird. But I picked up this comb. I guess we could bring this over here. So this comb is like a weird connector in between comb, bristle, and broom. Oh, here's a better blue one. This was actually a better connector. I think it's interesting that these things repeat themselves in the environment. And most, the average person would probably walk by and be like, oh, that's trash. But here's this like kind of interesting, unique object, you know? And like I said, as skateboarders, we're constantly like looking at the ground, you know? Most skateboarders are potentially looking for stuff to skateboard on. But it's just, this just so happens to kind of like, I don't know, fill the time in between that process, you know? It's just part of like the fabric of the city. This is just some of the post-it notes, dude. It takes some time to like find those things because they're not just like every, you know, you can't just walk out of the street and you're going to be like, oh, today I need to find this Pringles box. It's not like you, I mean, you could go to the store and buy one and throw it into the street, come back a couple days later, maybe it'll still be there. But that's not really how I do this stuff. So it makes it like a bit of like a treasure hunt sort of thing. I guess the idea would be to kind of like present them as like a collection. You know, the same way like people present like framed butterflies, you know, or whatever it is. Like, I guess that's kind of the idea. It's crazy shit, whatever. What are you gonna do? Basically, my objective has always been not to go sort of like onto something. You know, like this, when I look at it, this is like a channel and a vert ramp. My goal was to basically go on this and into this one, not onto it and off to the side. But here's the other thing. When I started to skate this thing, in fact, I think if you look in the footage, this dude is coming out of his door and he's like standing there and he's like basically kicking me out. So I knew that these spots were like, this dude, I know that this dude's always home. I'm surprised he's not even coming out now. So this thing, if you hit this door hard enough and it's got enough bounce, this thing will pull out of here. And if that thing pulls out of here while you're coming at it, it's gonna just basically pitch you to the ground. And if you don't know about those, you'll find out about them.
I want to know if
I'll cut your
have...
throat from your fucking head. No,
I
just came back to
the zone. We were just over there and I was like, oh, check this out. You could prop this thing up and go over the bar. And these two like older freaking maniacs came up.
Yeah. Fuck, I'm from New York. I'm from fucking East New York, Brooklyn.
Yeah, man.
He be a victim. Right.
I could kind of tell that they were like, you know, potentially gonna take his camera.
I'll tie you the fuck up.
No, man, he wasn't.
I thought you guys were talking about this dude.
I was like, hey, check this out. You know, I was like telling him like what I was gonna do. And I was like, you think I could do it? And they're like, ah, you can't do that.
If you guys want, I'm gonna jump over this thing for you. You wanna see it?
And I kind of got them like, you know, kind of distracted away from like Stuart, kind of.
Whoa.
Oh, that's gangster.
And sure enough, we became friends.
I can't do that shit.
But then he showed me the freaking razor. Didn't he pull it out on camera? Yeah. Then I thought about swallowing a razor. Like, that's some crazy control.
The world's largest mobile phone maker is warning that third quarter sales will be about 5% below the year ago level. This just in, you were looking at obviously a very disturbing live shot there. That is the World Trade Center, and we have unconfirmed reports this morning.
You know, I mean, I knew after 9/11, I knew something was up. I didn't think right away, like, I'm not going to say, like, I knew right away that it was a false flag, you know, operation, but, you know, for certain, it was like, okay, I need to pay attention to what's going on because this shit was happening in my freaking backyard. The term conspiracy, you know, to a certain extent, like, a lot of people don't realize this, but after the Kennedy assassination, the term conspiracy theory was sort of like, was cultivated by the Central Intelligence Agency throughout the media to be kind of like, okay, if you think that we killed the president, right, that concept is so batshit crazy that you are now a conspiracy theorist. So it was kind of developed by the agency to kind of like brand, to almost be a moniker for somebody that is crazy. I mean, if you break it down or look up the definition or whatever, a conspiracy just means two or more people conspiring to execute something, you know? And a lot of times it has like negative connotations connected to it, but like you and I can conspire to make $100, you know? We could conspire to, you know, engage in any type of, you know, sort of transaction or whatever, you know? There is a little thing back here. I can't remember. Maybe it's down this block. Yeah, this thing is so sick. But we never really skated this thing because it was almost like, I don't want to say we didn't have the skill to, like, you know, it was like dealing with the fucking projects. The projects right here were kind of crazier back then. I don't know, just dealing with the cars and ollieing up the curb, it just made it like whatever. But I don't know, I've recently kind of been into this thing.
Oh, step right in front. I waxed it a long time ago and it was like that. It's like,
yeah, I still like, there's still large swaths of this like little zone that I've never like gone behind all the different buildings and shit. Crusty, crusty one. That one's kind of dope, pizza. It's funny, like this would be such a dope like left breast logo tee, but this is the fruit is ba-boom. Post-it note. Kind of funny. So that's like in the wild. Some crusty hair, cigarette butt attached to it. This one's kind of cool. It's a blank one, but it's got that weird stain on it. So there you go. Merry Christmas. All right, let's get out of here.